In my reporter's notebook this morning, a visionary who helped to co-found the Cook County Forest Preserve 100 years ago this month. When it came into existence, it began acquiring land. Dwight Perkins was one of those co-founders, honored at a centennial observance. And the story that I heard there about what happened to him when he tried to clean up the Chicago Board of Ed in the early 1900s is astounding. He was the board's chief architect, but when Perkins refused to go along with several corrupt schemes, it was he who got hauled up on personnel charges. A four-day trial ended up with him being fired for insubordination.
I mean, the real issue was that he wouldn't specify the materials of some of the board members' companies for the construction of schools. And basically, they wanted him to quit, and he wouldn't quit. So finally, they were able to, after a trial, get rid of him for insubordination.
Now, it wasn't easy for Dwight Perkins and Jens Jensen to launch the Cook County Forest Preserve either. It took a 15-year battle that went from the General Assembly to the State Supreme Court.
I think they're visionary, and sometimes when you're visionary, you take a beating sometimes. But I do think we've come a long way.
It isn't easy to do stuff like that.
You know, when you think about an open lakefront in Chicago and you think about 69,000 acres of land around the third largest city in the country, it's not easy. There's a lot of pressures to develop it and to build other things. And even then, even 100 years ago, there was real pressure to do that. So they fought valiantly and they were successful, and we're the beneficiaries of that.
That was 100 years ago. Let's acknowledge the visionaries to whom we owe so much, including Dwight Perkins and Jens Jensen and all the other men and women that they worked with. Jensen, of course, was the landscape architect who also played a key role in the founding of the Forest Preserves of Cook County. Now, you can find interviews from today's program on myfoxchicago.com. Simply scroll over to the Politics tab at the top, then click on Fox 32 Sunday. For now, stay tuned for Fox News Sunday. That's next. And come back to Fox 32 News at 9 p.m. this evening and all through the week. We've got that city election coming up.